Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Thursday's Theology. My name is Jeff, and I'm your host. And before I start off with this week's episode, I have a confession to make. And that is, today's episode is revolving around the idea of systematic theology. And my confession is that it took me about a year and a half into seminary to really understand what systematic theology was. So I didn't go into seminary having an idea of like, oh, this is what it means, this is what it looks like, this is what the study of it is. It took me a very long time to truly understand what systematic theology meant and why it was important. So that is going to be the topic of today's episode, and that is, what is systematic theology and why is it important? So I have a dictionary definition of systematic theology, and that is the study of theology that seeks to give a coherent, comprehensive account of the whole. Systematics usually follow the pattern of beginning with the doctrine of God, to the doctrine of Christ, to the doctrine of the Spirit, and then to the doctrine of the church. So I think the easiest way that I can explain this is that it's very much like how math classes or history classes or any college courses are really constructed. And that is, you have an introductory course, you have an overview course, but then as you progress through the various fields of that subject, you start getting more and more complicated. So for instance, if you wanted to, I'm going to go and use physics again as an example, just because I have a few college students that I work with that are physics majors, and I've had some really, really interesting conversations with them. So shout out to them for being awesome and being super smart. But anyway, with physics, what happens is you don't jump in without having any understanding of what physics are. So you wouldn't sign up for a astrophysics or a quantum physics class without having gone through the pattern or the system of understanding what physics is. I would be completely lost in a quantum physics class if I had not been taking physics for years. And I think the same thing goes for theological classes as well, because if you want to jump into, say, missiology, which we'll be covering in a few weeks, or soteriology or hamartiology, which again, we're all going to be covering, all of those things are very specific and very much built off of understanding that has happened throughout the past few centuries. So when we look at systematic theology, we start with the theology of the early church. We start with the theology of who God is, because we need to have a firm foundation of who God is if we're going to start to understand, okay, who is Christ? And then once we understand who Christ is, who is the Holy Spirit? And then once we have a understanding of that, it's like, okay, what is then the theology of understanding what the role of the church is? So systematic theology is basically a complicated way of saying you're just going to studying the building blocks of the Christian faith and the Christian theology. And again, going back to this idea of school and university, myself, I'm a history major. And if I had jumped into a class of, let's say, the Great Depression. The Great Depression is a very, very specific area of focus within the overall subject of United States history. I would have a really hard time being able to zero in on the specificity of that time period if I hadn't been able to take classes leading up to that, saying, okay, here's the context of what's going on. Here's the class that speaks to the first 50 years before the Great Depression, and then understanding, you know, the forces, the economic forces, the social forces, all these different things that contributed to how devastating the Great Depression was. So if I had no previous understanding of United States history, I wouldn't jump into these specific classes. Otherwise, I would be lost. I had to start with the overviews of U.S. history. I had to start with the surveys of, you know, from colonization to Reconstruction and Reconstruction to present day. I had to have those classes because that gave me the necessary foundation for understanding the nuance and the specificity of why the Great Depression was so devastating. So the same thing goes in our understanding of systematic theology. And that's basically all that it is it's studying the building blocks and giving you a foundation for understanding why we believe what we believe in Christian theology and church. So yeah, it's really that simple. Systematic theology is just understanding in order what we believe. So yeah, that's it took me a year and a half into seminary to learn that. But now that I have learned it, it has helped me a lot, actually, understand why the church believes certain things about the Trinity, why the church believes certain things about how church should be run, et cetera, et cetera. So systematic theology is kind of a complicated way of revealing just a simple truth, and that is going throughout history and studying the building blocks and working towards a more nuanced understanding of who God is. So yeah, that is systematic theology. So thank you for joining me this week for Thursday's Theology. My name is Jeff, I'm your host. And again, remember, theology, it does not have to be that difficult. It is simply the study of who God is. Take care. We'll see you next week.